there's Smokey's prick. He was practicing it before the game. Indians, he knows that Scarecrow is bad at this song. He is out-strategizing his opponent. There is a good chance that we can see Smokey pull out another 2-0 here, because I know for a fact that Scarecrow is not a fan of this song.
Mm-hmm. One of the, again, they're good friends, and one of the bad things about being so close to someone is that they know everything about you, and now this is Smokey's pick. He's going to use his, kind of pull out the big guns against him. Again, Indian's not a difficult song, but it's a very annoying song, and if Scarecrow hates it, then it's done. That's it. But let's see. I mean, it's still anyone's game. I know there's a chord section toward the, kind of toward the middle of the song that can be kind of a slip up for other players, and then fast drumming kind of throughout the song is
most definitely. I 100%
kind of lower tier.
I 100% agree with that, Brock. I want to thank all 400 plus viewers currently watching on the stream. If you guys can tweet out for us that we are live and that we have this amazing match going on, we would greatly appreciate it. As we see some of the fast drumming that Brock was talking about that is intermittent throughout this song, there is just, it's very repetitive, you know, and I gotta be honest, I'm really happy we did this rule selection that we did. We have not seen the same song more than once yet tonight.
In fact, we've seen more tier 6 songs than any other song, so I think it's a very good idea. You know, we're not just hearing metal songs or just ones with, like, endless solos like Fury or Black Widow. As much as I enjoy those songs and as much as I enjoy playing them, it's good to get a wide range of songs, and it's better for spectators as well.
I 100% agree. Yet again, we have had a miss by Scarecrow. Yet again, the reason why Smokey would pick a song like this, knowing his opponent, picking out his weakness, and exploiting it. So with that being said, Smokey does have about an 8,000 point advantage in the song currently.
Wow.
Pretty insane, as we have to ban some people in the chat. Alright. Cool. With that being done, back to the actual game at hand. I don't know, I think unless something crazy happens here, I do think Smokey is going to be able to pull this out, which will set up an amazing grand finals with whoever wins the other match between Smegory and vVv Assai. I mean, yeah. How many epic wars have we seen between Asai and Smokyprogg over the years?
Far too many, but funny enough, I don't think Smokyprogg has ever actually lost to Asai in person. I know online there's been once or twice where he has lost to Asai, but in person, Smokyprogg has not lost to Asai. And especially since if they both make it to the finals, we will be hosting the match. Neither one is really going to have an advantage.
Right, so which makes it a little bit more like playing online, live instead of online, just because you do have that, you know, that host, that third party, to kind of make it an even playing field, both people experiencing the same lag. You know,
right.
Oh, a big slip up from Smokey, he does miss, does miss right there in the cord. So, Scarecrow catching up a little bit, it is a very close match, neck and neck. This might go down to the wire. If Scarecrow can hold on, this would push it to a third song. The tiebreaker in this round would be actually a repeat of something we have seen on the stream. That would be Holy Wars.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I don't know. These two would go... Oh, that would be a very, very close match.
Certainly something that I think both of them have had a lot of practice with, so... I definitely, if it goes to this, you know, I don't want to call it too early because, you know, there's still plenty of song left. Not too much, but still a little bit. But Holy Wars, I think, would be a good pick between the two. And it would be yet another tiebreaker.
Wow. You know, since that early miss by Scarecrow, we have not seen another miss from Drew. He is now over an 1,100 note streak. So, only about 4,500 points separate the two. That's about as close as you can get. That is literally one miss. You know, one note difference. Both players knocking out the trill rather easily. It's and a perfect activation from both of them as well going into the solo section. Barring any choke, Yeah, which Smokey is known to do from time to time.
Very much and so.
We've mentioned this before, but, you know, Smokey is consistent, but he does have his moments where he does choke. Mm-hmm. Even with that long streak from Drew, Scarecrow, it might not be enough. We're coming up to the end of the song, too. I don't know. Here we go with the last section with the fast drumming involved. And there's another miss from Smokey.
That
would be the choke we were talking about. The first meter is bouncing back and forth between the two. One more miss from Smokyprogg. If Scarecrow could keep the streak up, would secure this force. Oh my god, less than 1,000 point difference between the two. We do have one last activation coming up too, though. And neither of them have been... There we go, same activation.
Here we go, yep.
That is...
Oh, man.
As epically close as you could get a song like this. There's not much more to say but just to watch and see if Smokey slips or if he can hold on to his victory, and he does!
Wow.
Just a little less than 900 points between the two. Smokey secures another victory and forges his way into the winner's finals. Barely victorious in that song. Wow.